Okay, so once you've opened up the file, it'll open up on the Notes tab. So here we have some information on the different tests that have been used within GenResta. So the first one is the Wunderlich personnel test, which we've gone through in the previous videos. The second one, panel interviews. So the company uses this on the shortlist of candidates. It is compromised experience HR employees. However, there's also a line supervisor that tends to exert more influence. Okay, because typically it should be mutually agreed upon by all members of the panel. So it looks like there's some undue influence here. The interviews, they're roughly structured. So again, keeping that in mind when we're taking a look at the correlation scores for both the structured and unstructured, it should be a little bit higher than unstructured, but less than the structured correlation. All right, the next one, job skills profile test. So basically, we're looking at trying to match up the skills that a person may do within the test to what's being administered within the selection criteria here. And we're just assuming that all performance scores are unbiased and completely fair, because what we're doing, we're comparing the scores here against their performance in their annual performance rating. Okay, so now let's take a look at the report. We have different candidates. We have their score on the Wunderlich test out of 50, the interview scores out of 50, job skills profile at 100, and here the performance scores after 1 year from the annual performance review. We also have a total score here. So within each one, we're going to now begin comparing the test, or the results that they had in a particular test against their performance score. So to do that, we're going to use, we have it here, the CORREL formula. So equals CORREL. And I'm going to click here on the column heading B. So I'm selecting the entire range, comma, and I'm going to now click on the performance scores. So we're looking for a correlation between the Wunderlich test and their annual performance ratings. Now I can click on the column header as opposed to the individual cells because there's no irrelevant information below this table. All right, hit enter, and we have a correlation of 0.4. We'll do the same thing for the interview to performance, equals CORREL. Now I'll click on the interview, comma, performance. And it doesn't matter in which order I click. I could have clicked the performance score first and then the interview score, 0.02. And now for the job skills, performance scores. Well, I forgot, I pressed a period instead of the comma. There we go. So now what I can do is to see how the correlation changes by looking at the total score, which is basically adding up all the scores within the different tests, and compare that against performance scores. So I'll take performance scores, comma, and the total scores. And now we have the correlation of using all the selection tools against performance. So now that we have the correlations for the different tests within GenResta, how do these correlations compare to what research has been telling us? Well, the Wunderlich to performance, it's a cognitive ability test, we have a correlation of 0.4. Let's go back and take a look at what the research has stated. 5.1. Okay, let me put that as comparative. This is 0.51. How about interview to performance? Let's take a look at the slides. We have structured and unstructured. So because it's loosely structured, we'll take the correlation of 0.51. Or put 0.51 and put 0.31, right? Yeah, 0.31, there we go. In the job skills to performance, research tells us, job skills. So really this is work samples. So let's take a look, 0.54, all right. And we're getting 0.142. All right, so how do we make sense out of these numbers? I want you to pause the video before we go into my explanation to really consider this. What are these numbers telling us? So this is research, and these correlations are actual. Okay, so pause the video and look at the difference between them and try and understand, what does this actually mean? Once you have an idea or you have some thoughts, let's come back to the video. Okay, so let's consider the Wonderlic is a cognitive ability. Best case scenario, we can get 0.51. So I'm not too worried about this. Wonderlic is just one example of the tests that measure cognitive ability. Perhaps there's others. So that's fine. The one that really concerns me is this interview to performance. We're noticing a zero correlation. Basically, there's no relationship between the interview score and subsequently the performance. So, and whereas research is showing us the best case scenario is 0.51 for structured and 0.31 for unstructured. Well, I'm not entirely surprised by this. Number one, because we noticed within the notes for the interviews, we said that in practice, the line supervisors tended to exert more influence. So this line supervisor may be exerting more influence, but they actually know what they're doing. It doesn't appear to be the case. And it seems like, again, because HR, the panel is comprised of HR employees, they may be a little more timid in company with the line supervisor. So there's a huge problem here with the interview to performance. As an HR professional, this is clearly highlighting the fact that there's a real need to train hiring managers and line supervisors, especially perhaps some other HR employees who are conducting the interviews, on how to do a better job in the interview in order to increase that correlation significantly. And subsequently, the job skills test performance, we should be seeing 0.54. It's the highest that research is telling us. And yet we're at 0.142. So clearly, whatever test is being employed to select the different candidates for the different jobs are not suitable. So that needs to be scrapped completely as well too. So overall, there's some major problems with the different selection tools that the company is currently using in order to identify the best qualified candidates for each job. Now, on a side note, here's the real exciting part. What I'm seeing here is that this is an opportunity. If you see this within your own company, an opportunity for you to use multiple skills that you've learned through multiple courses. But it all starts with metrics and analytics. Number one, if you don't have this information in the company that you are working in, ask your manager to begin a program to start collecting this type of data. Collect the scores and pull out the performance ratings and start doing different testing to find out the correlations. It begins with metrics. For example, if you're in this company and you saw this, well, right away, you know, things have to change specifically on the interview. Well, you leverage the knowledge you've learned from your training development class to create some training for the hiring managers on how to interview properly. The other element comes into place is if you've taken the course on HR research, you know where to find these research reports, understand the correlations, and bring it all together. So you're basically taking the knowledge from three different courses and applying it. This is the exciting part that'll help increase your profile within the organization that you're working for. So really, really exciting. The key thing is, I know I kind of sound like a bit of a broken record here, it's begun because you understand the numbers, see the story that you're able to pull out because of metrics. All right, I know it's a bit of a shameless plug, but there you go. It is what it is. All right, so in the next video, we're going to move on and consider span of control.